Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Excel Clinic, the accountant series. Accountants prepare financial reports, management accounts every month, and sometimes more often than that. A very common scenario, you extract a detailed report or trial balance from your accounting system and summarize it into a balance sheet or profit and loss statement. Are you doing this? If so, please follow me. The tips and tricks I share will help you save time and say no to OT. The shortcoming of this approach is apparent when you do it again next month. Unless you have trial balance that is fixed, which is quite unlikely, you have to adjust the functions or formulas every month and every time you need to submit the financial reports. By saying fixed, I mean the sequence of the accounts don't change, no new accounts. If you reference to a cell or cells in the trial balance worksheets, and the trial balance expand the following month, you have to redo the referencing, or you have to check and recheck to make sure that you sum the right cells. The worst case is when the balance sheet doesn't balance, and you have, say, 100 lines in your trial balance. You need to find out which account you missed or double count. Okay, now, tips number one. If you want to summarize a detailed report, use a mapping table. Never ever use direct referencing. It will save you hours when you try to find out what caused the variance. Mapping table documents the relationship between the detailed report and the summary report. Another benefit is that you don't have to trace the formulas whenever your boss asks you, which line in balance sheets did you map this account to? What you need is just refer to the mapping table, which tells you how the data transformed. Now, it is time to build something from scratch. Before we build a mapping table, let's quickly draft the balance sheets and profit and loss statement. It is a good practice to start with the drafting of the final reports, then work backward. This practice will help you save time and efforts when you build Excel templates. It helps you to stay focused on what really matters. If you'd like to know more good spreadsheet design practices, comment below and let me know. I will do this really quick. One thing you need to take note when drafting this statement, do not repeat any caption. If you have trade and other receivables for both current and non-current, you have to distinguish them. This can be achieved by either indicating current or non-current in the caption, or you can use another column to indicate so. This is because if you have two captions that are exactly the same, when we map, Excel will not know which exact line a deposit account, for example, should go to. Next, add a worksheet, call it mapping. Copy the account list from trial balance and paste it here. Then, add two columns, mapping for balance sheets and mapping for profit and loss statement. Populate the balance sheets and P&L captions to which each of these accounts should be grouped to. Exact same wordings as the caption in your draft final reports, please. No extra space, dash, consistent, consistent, consistent. We have the draft reports, the mapping table, and now we need to work on the source data, the trial balance. We need two helper columns to map this account's code to the report caption. Where should we insert these helper columns? Technically, you can have them before the trial balance columns or after, and if you like, you can cut in between. But I would prefer to do it before the trial balance columns. I will never insert helper columns in between the source data columns. Come next month, you will be replacing the trial balance. If the helper columns are in between the trial balance column, you will have to copy and paste twice. Being lazy, I will never do that. I will also avoid inserting helper columns after. It doesn't really matter to the most diligent people, but to be safe, just in case I copy an additional column from the trial balance file next month, it will replace the helper columns and erase the functions I built. So, let me add two helper columns before the trial balance sheet columns. Call them balance sheet and profit and loss. Enter the function. You can use VLOOKUP if you prefer, but since I'm using Office 365, I will use the newer function, XLOOKUP. Equals XLOOKUP. The first argument is the account number. I will make column C absolute so that I can copy to the profit and loss column later without changing the function. The second argument is the lookup array. Go to the mapping table, select column A. Again, I will make column A absolute so that I can copy to the profit and loss column later. The third argument is the column C of the mapping table. We don't have to make column C absolute because when I copy to profit and loss column, I want it to move to the next column. Then we copy and paste it to the rest of the rows and to the profit and loss column. But we got a problem here. For those balance sheets account, it returns zero in the profit and loss column. Does it matter? Well, no. But if you think it is really ugly and you want to remove it, you can. Select the column, click on the tiny arrow in the number group of the home tab. Go to custom, type 0, semicolon, dash 0, semicolon, semicolon, and the at sign. What does this secret code mean? There are four arguments here, each segregated by a semicolon. The first argument is the number format where the number is positive. The second argument is the number format for negative number. The third argument is the number format for zero. So it should be empty because we do not want it to return zero. The last argument is for text and the at sign represent that. Now let's go back to the final reports and add a function to retrieve the data from the trial balance. The function we use is sumifs. You can also use sumif without the s. It works about the same, but the sequence of the arguments is slightly different. Equal sumifs. The first argument is the sum range. We will take the debit column first and work on credit column later. The second argument is the criteria range, which is the balance sheets column. The third argument is the criteria. This sumifs will return the sum of debit columns for all rows in the trial balance that are tagged to property, plant and equipment. So PPE is our criteria. To get the credit columns, the function is about the same. So let me copy the function. The credit column in our trial balance is showing positive number, but we know debit and credit should offset. So enter the minus sign, then paste the function that we copied earlier. We need to do a little tweak. Change the debit column, which is column E, to column F. Depending on your accounting system, some display debit and credit in a single column and denote credit by showing a negative number. Personally, I prefer this kind of trial balance for an obvious reason. It saves the second part of the formula. I'm lazy and that's why I hate OT. Copy the cell and paste it for the other asset lines. How about the liabilities and equity lines? Well, personally, I prefer to show credit in negative number. But if you are presenting this report to non-accountant who doesn't really understand debit and credit, you might want to display it in positive number. To do that, just wrap the formulas for asset in brackets and add a minus sign in front. Then copy and paste to the other lines. Now let's add the subtotals and totals. I will use the simplest function, sum. The very first Excel function my father taught me more than 20 years ago, and I'm still using it now. Some would argue that subtotal is a better function, and I don't dispute that. But to make things simpler for this video, I will just stick to sum. And if you'd like to know more about subtotal versus sum, comment below and let me know. One tip here, when I sum a range of cells, and I know that I will add additional rows in the future, I will add an additional blank row below the sum range. To make it less apparent, I will reduce the row height like this. But why? If you add a row within a sum range, the sum range will be expanded automatically. But if you add a row outside the sum range, then the sum function will not be updated. So this little trick will help you save some time next month if you need to add an additional line to your balance sheets. Accounting basic. Net asset equal liability. Being an accountant, I love to check and make sure it balanced. Do a simple check to make sure that the balance sheet is balanced out and make the font smaller. I shall now apply the same process to profit and loss. Now here you go, a reusable financial reports template in Excel. Let me know what topic you'd like me to cover next by commenting below. Follow me, no OT. Subscribe to the channel, turn on the notification so that you will not miss the next episode. Share with your fellow Excel users and say no to OT. See ya next week.